Consider the difference between art and most other trades. In the art, our filter is a defining factor of the work. In science or technology, the aims are different. The reason we create art isn't for the intention of making something useful for someone else. We create to express who we are and where we are on our journey. Art is not a luxury, it's actually a sustenance. Ethan Hawke. Most people don't spend a lot of time thinking about poetry, right? They have a life to live and they're not really that concerned about Allen Ginsberg's poems or anybody's poems. Until their father passed away, they go to the funeral, or you lose a child. Somebody breaks your heart, they don't love you anymore. And all of the sudden you are desperate for making sense out of this life. And ask yourself, has anybody ever felt this bad before? How did they come out of this cloud? Or the inverse, something great. You met somebody and your heart explodes, right? You love them so much you can't even see straight. You know you are dizzy. Did anybody feel like this before? What is happening to me? And that's when art is not a luxury, it's actually a sustenance. In other words, it's a food for your soul.
Speech from Jordan Peterson. Your brain is set up to produce positive emotion. Literally, this is what positive emotion system does. It computes decrease between you and a goal. So if you had the goal, and you see that you've done something that move you towards it, your brain releases a dopamine hit, and that makes you feel good, and it strengthens the neural circuit that moved you forward. It does both of those. That's reward and reinforcement. And what's that mean is, if you don't have a goal, you have no positive emotion. When people say, you know, they're aimless there, they're partly telling that you're anxious, but they're also telling you that they have no positive emotion.
It took me 9 years to learn this, but I'll teach you in a minute. Here are 10 uncomfortable truths about life. 9 years. One, a salary is a drug your employer gives you to forget your dream. Two, if you continue to wait for a right time, you'll waste your entire life and nothing will happen. Three, even when you trust your close friends and family, let them know nothing about you. Four, you'll lose 99% of your close friends if you start upgrading your life. Five, you'll be 10 times better if you forgive your parents and stop blaming them for your problems. Six, you become more mature when you train yourself to take nothing personally. Seven, you don't need 100 self-help books. All you need is action plus self-discipline. Eight, the most difficult mission on earth is to focus on your dreams, and the easiest task is to complain. Nine, by age 30, your inner circle must be focused on making money, building your body, and start a family. 10, people are stuck in toxic relationships because they're afraid to be alone. You have to be tough as a damn boot to be good, because you have to stand your ground when you need to stand in your ground. And you have to be able to say no when it's time to say no, and you have to mean it. So then you have to think and plan strategically, so that when you're gonna say no, you can mean it and it will stick, you know? And that takes a certain amount of integrated malevolence, I would say. And once it's integrated, it's not malevolence anymore, it's become strength. It's strength of character, the ability to stand your ground. And you have to cultivate that, at least in part of telling the truth. So you take your place in the world as a decent person, as a decent citizen, and then you play the hierarchy game properly, and that is to stand up straight. It's like the world is an onslaught. You've got the tyranny of culture to deal with. You've got the catastrophe of nature. You've you've got your own damn malevolence and ignorance, right? All coming at you. Plus the incredible, complicated, indeterminate potential of the future. That's all coming at you at any moment. And it's all your responsibility. You can cringe away from it and be victimized by it and be bitter and cynical about it, and no wonder, because it can be painful. Or you can just turn around and say, man, bring it on, because there's more to me than there is to the catastrophe. This is the definition of strength explained by Mr.